last week on Game Gods.
There, done. That's one down, four to go.
Who is it?
It's a block number.
Might as well answer it.
Thane, Sky, Cole, Zay, can you hear me?
I am in the basement, the game cave. It's complete anarchy above ground. Nuclear winter. I went to sleep. I had a dream. It told me to go downstairs to the game cave. Instead, I foolishly poured myself a glass of milk. Did you ever experience drinking milk in a dream? It usually doesn't happen. Maybe sometimes, but not often. It's symbolic stuff. Really symbolic, guys. I don't want to diverge too much, but suffice it to say, I drank the milk. Only it wasn't milk. It was Garmin Bozia wearing the mask of milk. And it was chocolate, so I wanted it more. So like I said, I drank it. And now I'm here, stuck in between worlds. Not able to do much except communicate with you whenever I get a chance. Whenever I can review a game. This just came hot off the presses. Real hot stuff. Real new. Computron is back. You thought you destroyed him, but you didn't. And now he's back. He has stolen all the power from Canada and has diverted it into his mainframe. I don't know what he is up to, but it's probably not kosher. Like eating pork for someone who is Jewish, so I hear. And Computron is the one making you play shitty games. It's him. He could change his voice on the phone to make it sound like any of you. Don't trust anyone. Not unless they put it in a video. That's the one thing Computron can't control. That's why he partnered with Garfunkel. Garfunkel is born from VHS tape. He rules video. He's the only one who can prevent you from making the videos and reversing the curse. But not to worry. I'll help you in your quest. Let's do it, my bros from Idaho.
Review some games for Rad Katz. Hope this will work. This. I need to get in the right headspace if I'm gonna clean up this mess. Shopping list. Up in here. most incredible night of my life.
Up in here, up in here.
Hello, who's this?
Which I come back for revenge.
Oh, hold on, we're getting another phone call.
Sup, fuckers? Here to fuck shit up.
Wait, hold on, somebody else wants to join.
Hey, I'm calling to tell you that landlines are analog and I can still use the one I have in my house to call you without the power being on. Plus, I have a gas generator that can run the lights in my house for up to a month. And Computron and Garfunkel will never know.
Pat, we're kind of in a conversation with everybody right now, those two included.
Oh, sh**. I oughta a o-gay.
Wait, who's gay?
Hey, Sky, put everyone else on mute. All clear? You don't sound very confident, but I don't have much time.
Pat, you're gonna have to speak up.
We have to think of a plan to get rid of Computron and Garfunkel once and for all. Do you have any ideas on how we might be able to do that?
I'm sure we could think of something, but we need to get through these game reviews so we can live to see another day.
The first game is the eternally painful Eternity, The Last Unicorn.
First off, we're going to say that this has no relation to the movie The Last Unicorn. This is some shitty RPG inspired by Norse mythology or something like that.
One positive is that you play as a sexy elf chick, but there are other games where you play as sexy elf chicks, so there's not much going for it.
This game has such a generic fantasy setting that it looks like a Lord of the Rings fan film. It also mentions something about elderly scrolls, more like elderly scrotums. This game is very boring, as combat is tedious and at times frustrating.
The controls are very clunky, like an old survival horror game, and some asshole decided to bring fixed camera angles to this shit show in 2019. In an era where we have long figured out how to manipulate in-game cameras to perfection, fixed camera angles were a fan favorite amongst the development team. Go figure.
This game is also pretty shallow in the RPG elements, so this game feels more like Light Souls. Get it? Because it's light on the content. And it's trying to be Dark Souls? To just wrap this up.
Should you put The Last Unicorn down? Yes. Yes, you should.
Pat here from the basement. The Game Cave. Actually, it's not the basement, it's my dining room. I went stir crazy and smoked a bunch of heavy stuff. Not tobacco, if you know what I mean. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Devil's lettuce, guys. Wacky tobacky. I have to say that it helped me endure the video games I had to review. Without it, I would have been lost. Lost, guys. Up the creek without a paddle. What can I say about Rune 2? I hate slick and pretty things. I prefer mistakes and accidents, which is why I like things like cuts and bruises. They're like little flowers. I've always said that if you have a name for something like cut or bruise, people will automatically be disturbed by it. But when you see the same thing in nature and you don't know what it is, it can be very beautiful. That's the way I feel about Rune 2. It often feels like a bunch of stories and ideas packed together to attempt to make a cohesive story, like a bunch of accidents. But these aren't beautiful accidents. Along with the bugs and glitches, it was hard to get a consistent feeling of where the game wanted to go. Maybe with a few updates, the game will offer a more consistent experience. Maybe I'll still get boners when I'm in my 90s. Who knows? They should re-release this game entirely. Entirely, guys! Patches are fine, but they need to go back and add little bits to the story to flesh it out. The developers should be forced to repent inside the Black Lodge until they vow never to repeat this offense again.
Take your antidepressants for this next game, Paranoia. Happiness is mandatory.
Right now, you can't buy this game. It was an Epic Game Store exclusive, but they removed it for no given reason. But that reason might be that it's a pile of shit.
So why is this game on this list? F*** you, that's why.
This game looks like if XCOM and Bioshock had a baby, and then they dropped the baby on its head.
This game has interesting ideas, like how you have to keep your characters in line, or else you will get penalized, but it gets pretty frustrating when the game isn't consistent with what you're doing wrong, making you feel like a dog in an electrified cage. Pretty f***ed up, if you ask me.
The combat gets pretty dry after a while, with mostly the same enemy types. You probably get more enjoyment putting your dick in a rotisserie chicken from Costco.
Even though these graphics look like nasty man ass, the writing is alright and can probably keep you going through this game, if you could buy it. But you can't. It's a real shame.
If you're paranoid that this game existed, just pretend it didn't.
Pat here again with another review. I'm reaching for another joint because I quit smoking. Cigarettes, that is. But now I'm hooked on the green stuff. I quit smoking when Computron came to Canada. Couldn't find cigarettes. I was really depressed about it. I love smoking. I love fire. I miss lighting cigarettes. I like the whole thing about it. And now people like Bloomberg have made animals out of smokers, and they think that if we stop smoking, everyone will live forever. What can I say about Decay of Logos? It's like the developers tried to put a compelling spin on the beloved Dark Souls formula. To that I say, even bad coffee is better than no coffee at all. But while it succeeds in creating a beautiful world of interesting lore, it falters at the task of offering a well-tuned and fun combat system. To me, that doesn't make sense. Now, personally, I know that everything shouldn't make sense. I also don't think that people accept the fact that life doesn't make sense. I think it makes people terribly uncomfortable. And where things should make sense is video games. Decay of Logos seemed like it could be a good game at first, but make no mistake, it's deeply flawed and badly conceptualized in a way that few could pull off. You won't get into that safe zone where you feel in control of your character's destiny. I like to get into the safe zone and stay there, sometimes for long periods of time. It's comforting, like when I sit in a donut shop to drink coffee and reflect. This was before COVID, mind you. There's a safety in thinking in a donut shop, guys. I would highly recommend it. You can have your coffee or tea in your donut, and you can go off into strange, dark areas of your mind, and always come back to the safety of the donut shop. Unless you're a masochist, I can't advise going anywhere near the atrocity that is called Decay of Logos. That's it for me, guys. Keep your eye on the donut and not on the hole.
What the hell is a warder? Anyways, this is a Hell Warders.
This game looks like auto chess for lazy fucks. It's got that Dark Souls vibe with worse frame rate than the vanilla version of Blighttown. What?
This is a tower defense game, but we all know that the best tower defense games have monkeys throwing darts at balloons. So this game is already a failure.
You place your troops around an area, watch them lifelessly fight enemies in front of you. You also take part in the fight, and you also feel lifeless playing this game.
The story is pretty generic and not worth talking about. This game in general is not worth talking about. Let's send this game to the second deepest pits of hell. Why not the deepest, you ask? Well, because there is a girl with anime titties at the beginning.
I love anime titties.
Me too, dude.
So many. Oh.
Oh!
Got an idea yet?
What if we challenge them to a wet t-shirt contest?
How about this? I think the best way to destroy both Computron and Garfunkel is to complete all the videos, upload them all, but wait to publish the last video after Computron and Garfunkel cross over into our dimension to claim our souls, so that we can break the curse and bring Computron and Garfunkel into physical form so they can be killed.
Great idea, Pat. Do we wait till day 7, or do we just wait for them to jump out of the computer screens?
I don't have a f***ing clue. It's not like I've done this before. Something will happen.
What about the time zones? You're in Eastern and we're in Mountain.
You got the call, didn't you? That means it'll probably happen in your time zone. At the stroke of midnight, or at 10 p.m. Eastern, I'll be ready to not hit publish and wait for Computron to enter into our dimension with a gun aimed at his head. I suggest you do the same when Garfunkel scratches his piss-covered and likely hepatitis-infected paws at your back door.
Sounds like a plan.
Fools. We'll be ready for them.
GameGovTV and Rad Katz have been collaborating on YouTube since the summer of 2017.
We've produced dozens of game reviews, comedy sketches, and music videos together. But we've never actually met.
We want to fly Pat Andrel, the resident game god, out to Logan, Utah to have him meet us in person and have him stay with us for 1 week.
The $500 is strictly to cover a flight from Toronto, Ontario, to Salt Lake City, Utah. When we are finally united, we will spend an entire week together, collaborating and filming as many comedy sketches, music videos, and game reviews as we can.
We will also try as many YouTube challenges as humanly possible without injuring ourselves too bad.
What up, Rad Katz? What up, my bros from Idaho?
Bros in Idaho!
Bros in Idaho!
Bros in Idaho!
Here we go!
Here we go.
Here we go.
Keep it rad.
Here we go.
Links in the description.
Check it out.
Come on, donate.
We love you.
We love all of you.